فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي صير الدين مراتب ودرجات وجعل للعلم به أصولا ومهمات، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله حقا، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صدقا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى، my beloved brothers and sisters, today بإذن الله الكريم is our last day in our dawrah, in the barnamij in which we named barnamij Dabtul Ilm, precision in knowledge. And this was the first year in which we did it. We are going to be doing بإذن الله الكريم today the last two books. We're going to do this kitab, which is Manzumatul Qawa'id al-Fiqhiyya, written by Shaykh Abdul Rahman ibn Nasir al-Sa'di. And we'll do بإذن الله الكريم kitab Fadl al-Islam. سم.
الحمد لله العلي الأرفق وجامع الأشاء والمفرق للنعم الواسعة الغزيرة والحكم الباهرة الكثيرة، ثم الصلاة مع سلام دائم على الرسول القرشي الخاتم وآله وصحبه الأبرار الحائز مراتب الفخار. اعلم بديت أن أفضل من علم يزيل الشك عنك والدرن ويكشف الحق
لمن قلوبي ويوصل العبد إلى المطلوب. The author رحمه الله العلامة عبد الرحمن ابن ناصر السعدي started the kitab with basmala and then ثم ثنى بالحمدلة and then after that he praised Allah سبحانه وتعالى and then after that he sent peace and salutation on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and on the family of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and on his companions. And those three are the manners and the etiquettes in when authoring a book. Then the author rahimahullah, he said, اعلم نو هديت أن أفضل المنن. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you. أن أفضل المنن, from the greatest of blessing is علم, a knowledge. يزيل الشك عنك والدرن, that will remove two things from you, الشك, which is doubt, and الدرن, which is the filth and the dirt that may fall to your heart. So knowledge removes two things. It removes الشبهات, which is doubt, and it also removes الشهوات, which is desires. So the word yuzilu shakka is shubuhat. Waddaran is shahawat. Knowledge, it removes those two and it gets rid of it. Then the author said, وَيَكْشِفُ الْحَقَّ لِذِي الْقُلُوبِ وَيُوصِلُ الْعَبْدَ إِلَى الْمَطْلُوبِ. And he told us two things in which knowledge brings about. And that is, it removes the truth for you. وَيَكْشِفُ الْحَقَّ, it makes the truth apparent to you. Knowledge will allow that have to happen for you. And the second thing which knowledge does for you is وَيُوصِلُ الْعَبْدَ إِلَى الْمَطْلُوبِ, it allows the slave to reach his final goal in which he's looking for. The difference between the two is the last two, which is the two things that knowledge brings about. The difference between the two is one is connected to the beginning of your path, which is وَيَكْشِفُ الْحَقَّ لِذِي الْقُلُوبِ, it makes the truth clear to you, that's the beginning. وَيُوصِلُ الْعَبْدَ إِلَى الْمَطْلُوبِ, it is connected to the ending of the person's life. Knowledge brings about those two, and it repels and it removes those two. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us knowledge that will benefit us. Naam.
فاحرص على فحمك للقواعد جامعة المسائل الشوارد لترتقي في العلم خير مرتقى وتقتفي سبل الذي قد وفقا وهذه قواعد نظمتها من كتب أهل العلم قد حصلتها جزاهم المولى عظيم الأجر والعفو مع غفرانه والجر.
The author رحمه الله, when he mentioned and he spoke about the virtues of knowledge and how beneficial, how knowledge is of great benefit, he pointed out the path in which a person can attain knowledge and he can gain knowledge. And that is by knowing the comprehensive principles. The comprehensive principles, if you study them, it's a path to learn knowledge and it's a path to attain solid understanding of the religion. He says, فَحْرِصْ strive عَلَى فَهْمِكَ لِلْقَوَاعِدِ in understanding principles. جَامِعَةِ comprehensive principles. جَامِعَةِ الْمَسَائِلِ الشَّوَارِدِ those comprehensive principles deal with, it deals with فُرُوع sub-branches. It'll be easy for you to bring back the sub-branches back to the comprehensive principles. Because no one has the life to live, to learn every single sub-branch. We're not able to do that. And not anyone from amongst us is. We're all going to die and there's more to learn. But the person gives more time to the qawa'id kulliyah, the comprehensive, he gives importance to the qawa'id, the comprehensive principles. Because it's easy then to bring the furu', the sub-branches back to it. And that's something a student of knowledge does. And from the qawa'id is al-qawa'id al-fiqhiyah. And this is what the author means here. That's his intent here. Qawa'id usuli, qa'ida means technically, the word qa'ida, it means qadiyatun kulliyatun tantabiqu ala juz'iyatiha min abwabin mutaaddida. Qa'ida technically means sa qadiyatun kulliyah. It's an issue that deals with, but it's something that deals with many different sub-branches from different chapters. The poet, he said, قَضِيَّةٌ فِي شَأْنِهِمْ كُلِيَّةٌ فِي طَيِّهَا الْإِدْرَاجُ لِلْجُزْئِيَّةِ. So in the definition I gave, it encompasses 4 points. The first one is, أنها قضية, it's a matter. قضية here means what the usuliyin refer to as khabar. And what did we say khabar means? ما يلزم الصدق أو الكذب. It's anything which you can say, it's true or it's a lie. That's what قضية means. كلية means what? Kulliyah means comprehensive. The third one, which is tantabiqu ala juz'iyat, it means a afrad mukhtalifa. Many different things fall under it. Abwab mutaaddida, it means it enters different chapters. It's not specific to one thing. But when you say qa'ida fiqhiyya, you just have to say qadiyatun kulliyatun fiqhiyya. It's specific only to fiqh. Whereas qa'ida is general to everything. You can make qa'ida aqadiyya if you want. You can make qa'ida for aqida if you want. But here it's not qawa'id aqida related. It's qawa'id in fiqh. نعم.
النية شرط لسائر الأعمال من الصلاة والفساد للأمل. الدين مبني.
The author رحمه الله, he says, والنية شرط لسائر العمل بها الصلاح والفساد للعمل. The author رحمه الله, this is the first قاعدة he started with. And it is the قاعدة known as الأعمال بالنية. That actions are what is intended by it. The reason why the author rahimahullah started with this, because the qa'id al-a'malu bin niyat is Ummul Qawa'id al-Fiqhiyya, is the mother of all of the Qawa'id al-Fiqhiyya, because of the importance connected to the intention. Intention means in the Sharia, إِرَادَةِ الْقَلْبِ الْعَمَلَ تَقَرُّبًا إِلَى اللَّهِ, is the heart coming with an action to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Majority of the fuqaha, they say this qa'idah is الْأُمُورُ بِمَقَاصِدِهَا. Majority of the fuqaha, the jurists, they word it as الْأُمُورُ بِمَقَاصِدِهَا. Matters are what is intended by it. This statement, which is al-umur bi maqasidiha, is not a good usage for two reasons. The first one is the word al-umur. What enters it is dawat, and dawat are things, objects. When you say the word al-umur in the language, it also brings in objects and things. And we do, ahkam al-shar'iyya is not connected to things. It's connected to what? The actions of who? The actions of the slaves is connected to. It's not connected to us. Is it connected to us? It's not connected to us. It's connected to our actions. So when you say umur, you're connecting it to us and you're connected to the things. The second one is al-umur, the word umur. Again, no one can connect intention to a matter, a umur. So for those two reasons, it's not the best wording to say. So what we should use is the statement of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, which is al-a'malu bin niyyat or al-a'malu bin niyyah. That's the best way, that's the best to say it. What is studied in this chapter of al-umur, al-a'malu bin niyyah, the actions are what is intended by it, is the intention is the asas. That the intention is the foundation. And every single person is rewarded in accordance to that intention which they come with. The author's statement here, he says, "An-niyyatu shartun lisa'iril amal." That is a condition, a prerequisite for every action. Does the author mean by this every action? Because when you say an-niyyatu, the intention is a prerequisite لِسَائِرِ الْعَمَلِ, does he mean جميع العمل, all of actions? The scholars who translated and explained this book, they said this is عَامٌ مَخْصُوص. Because if I want to pay a person back their debt, do I have to come with intention for the debt to be accepted? No. If I want to provide for my family member, my children, do I have to come with an intention for it to be accepted? No. What about if I want to remove filth from myself, do I have to come with intention? This action is accepted. No one's going to request from you to clean that dirt again because you didn't come with an intention. Now.
الدين مبني على المصالح في جلبها ودرء الخبائح فإن تزحم عدد المصالح يقدم الأعلى من المصالح وضده تزاحم المفاسد
The author rahimahullah, he goes into another qa'ida, which is أن الدين مبني على الجلب المصالح ودرء المفاسد, that the religion is built upon bringing about good and repelling and removing evil. The word جلب, it means to bring about, التحصيل والجمع, And the word الدرع means الدفع والمنع. It is to push away something. So that the religion is built upon that. And the way that the religion brings about مصالح is in two ways. The first one is تأسيس المصالح. It actually brings the مصالح. It places it as a foundation. أيبتداؤها. The second one is تكميل المصالح. It completes the مصالح. It makes it complete, full. It adds onto it. If there's already مصلحة there, it makes it even more. As for when we look at the religion in terms of the mafasid, is also looked at it from two different ways. The first one is daruha, it repels it, it removes it. So it doesn't even happen and it doesn't take place. And the second one is taqliluha, it lessens it. So the statement that's more complete in terms of this qa'ida would be what? الدين مبني على تحصيل المصالح وتكميلها ودرء المفاسد وتقليلها. That the religion is built upon bringing about masalih and completing it and repelling the mafasid and lessening it. Because sometimes it can't remove it in totality, it lessens it. What's a maslaha? Many people say, "Akhi, this is a maslaha for the religion, maslaha for this and maslaha for that." Maslaha is ismun, it's a term lil ma'mur bihi shar'a. Maslaha is a term that's used for whatever the Sharia commands. Two things is what the Sharia commands. It commands al-fara'id, the obligatory things, which the Sharia commands, but it commands it in a forceful manner. And the second one is al-nawafil, the voluntary, is what is the Sharia also commands it, but it doesn't command it in a forceful manner. The second one is the mafsada. What's the mafsada? The mafsada is a term used for what the Sharia has prohibited. But it's only used for what the Sharia has prohibited على وجه الإلزام in a forceful manner. And mafasid is only connected to muharramat, things that are haram. The mubah and the makruh can be a maslaha and it can be a mafsada. Because of an external matter that makes it. Whereas the maslaha, it encompasses what? The fard and the nafl only. And the mafasid is specific to the haram. What's remaining? The other two that's remaining, which is the mubah and the makruh, they can either be masalih sometimes, or they can either be from the mafasid. You can't say that this is maslaha because it's mubah, or it is maslaha because it's what? It's makruh, or the opposite, in and within itself. You can only say it because of an external matter. There's something which is the author mentions here, which is known as تزاحم المصالح والمفاسد. When the masalih and the mafasid are, they're crowding one another. تزاحم, when is something is made, you have to basically prioritize one over the other. You're in a predicament, you're in a situation where the masalih and the mafasid are doing تزاحم. In other words, you're unable to do one of the two. It's called, the word تزاحم المصالح it means امتناع فعل إحدى المصلحتين إلا بترك الآخر. You're not able to do the two maslahas. You'd have to take one of the two maslaha. This is called تزاحم المصالح وتزاحم المفاسد. The same is تزاحم المفاسد. امتناع ترك إحدى المفسدتين إلى بفعل الآخر. If you leave one of the mafsada, you're going to have to do the other one. The word that's used for maslaha is to do. And the mafsada, what's used for it is to leave. So the maslaha you do. Whichever the two maslaha you do, you're going to leave the other one. And the mafasid is whichever of the two you leave, you're going to do the other one. So if two masalih are running besides one another, the author clearly told you, he said, فَإِن تَزَاحَمْ عَدَدُ الْمَصَالِحِ يُقَدَّمُ الْأَعْلَى مِنَ الْمَصَالِحِ. If they are competing with one another, two maslaha, you take the greatest of the two. And if two mafasids are running beside one another and you're going to have to, you're going to fall into one of the two, then you take the lesser of the two. وَضِدُّهُ تَزَاحُمُ الْمَفَاسِدِ يُرْتَكَبُ الْأَدْنَى مِنَ الْمَفَاسِدِ. You fall into, or you do, the lesser of the two. What about if we've now learned if two mafasid masalih are running beside each other, how to deal with it? We've also learned two mafasid that are running beside each other, which of those two we need to fall into. What about if there is a maslaha and a mafsada? If there is a maslaha and a mafsada, whichever of those is rajih, are you with me, brothers? You got a maslaha to do, but if you do the maslaha, you're going to fall into a mafsada. In order to do this maslaha, a mafsada is going to happen. Which one do I take? If the maslaha is higher and the mafsada is very little, then you take whichever of those is higher.
What's the rajih?
Rajih means higher. The maslaha here is more, the mafsada is little. Are you with me, brothers? What do you do here? You can't leave this maslaha which is very big, even though there is a mafsada in there. You take the maslaha which is rajiha. If the mafsada is rajiha, of course you don't take it. You leave it. Are you with me? What about if the maslaha and the mafsada are the same? The maslaha and the mafsada are equal, then dar'u al-mafasid muqaddamu al-ajal bil-masalih. Repelling and removing the mafsada takes precedence over bringing about any good this time. So the correct way of using daf'ul mafasid muqaddamun ala jalb al masalih is when the masalih and the mafasid are equal. Qarafi is the one who pointed that out. It is not talking about when there is rajih, there's a maslaha which is rajiha. So we learned the following things in this particular point. The first one is two masalih running besides one another, or five or whatever, يُقَدَّمُ عَلَاهَا, we will take the highest of them. The second martaba that we learned was what? The two mafasid running besides one another, we will fall into and we will take and we give precedence to the lesser of the two. We also took ازْدِحَامُ الْمَصَالِحِ وَالْمَفَاسِدِ. When the masalih and the mafasid are what? We mentioned three forms it comes in. The first one is, they are, one is higher than the other. So the maslaha is higher and the mafsada is lesser. We take which one? The maslaha. The second one was what? The mafsada is higher and the maslaha is little. We repel the maslaha, mafsada then. And the third form was what? When they are equal. And we gave the qa'idah, which is dar'ul mafsadati awla min jalbil maslaha. We will what? We repel the evil to bring about good. Naam.
ومن قواعد الشريعة التيسير في كل أمر لا له تأثير وليس واجب بلا اقتدار ولا محرم مع الضرار وكل مأمور مع الضرورة بقدر ما تحتاجه الضرورة.
The author رحمه الله, he goes into another qa'ida which the scholars call And it's very well known as al-mashaqqatu tajlibu al-taysir. Al-mashaqqatu tajlibu al-taysir. The using of the word al-mashaqqa, Sheikh Abdul Rahman Nasir al-Saudi didn't use. If you look at it, he says, وَمِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرِيعَةِ التَّيْسِيرُ فِي كُلِّ أَمْرِ نَابَهُ تَعْسِيرُ. تَعْسِيرُ is what he used. He doesn't use the word mashaqqa. Because in the Quran, what comes is the word usr, which is ta'sir. And mashaqqa doesn't come. Allah says in the Quran, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah doesn't even want usr for you. He wants yusr for you. So the ta'bir, the usage of the word in the sharia is what? Usr. And that is more befitting to be used than the word al-mashaqqa. What would even be better than all of that would be to use the Prophet's statement alayhi salatu wasalam, which is ad-deenu yusr. The religion is yusr. That's it. You don't have to be in qa'idah where you change. You can just come with what the Prophet came with, which is ad-deenu yusr. The religion is easy. It's the hadith Sahih Bukhari min hadith Abi Hurairah. So the ease of the sharia is general. And when you say ad-deenu yusrun, it's even better. You know why? Because when you say al-mashaqqatu tajribu al-taysir, according to, if you use even the statement of the Shaykh, which is al-taysiru yajlibu al-taysir, if you take the wording that the author uses here, or himself, it's not complete. The reason is because it only looks like that the ease comes when there's hardship. But the statement of the Messenger, it shows that the religion is always easy. It's always ease. Okay? And if you do find hardship in the religion, it's not because the religion is hard, it's because there's deficiency in you. Are you with me, brothers? That the hardship is connected to you, the hardship is connected to you because the same person will be doing the same action and say, no, I don't find it as a problem. Because of, mashallah, his obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how righteous he is. So the usage of the word, we've kind of chosen not to use it.